Millions of Americans cope with joint pain due to injury or disease every day. Our experts discuss the causes of joint pain and how conservative treatments can be a start to relieving symptoms.
Joint fibrosis is a condition where an otherwise normal joint forms scar tissue and then becomes stiff, and that stiffness can lead to loss of motion and can cause pain. Osteoarthritis is a condition where the normal cartilage on the ends of the bones is lost, and that can be lost for any number of reasons, and that loss of cartilage can also cause joint stiffness and pain.
According to the CDC, 350 million people worldwide suffer from arthritis. 54 million of those are in the United States. 21 million Americans suffer from osteoarthritis, and 2.1 million suffer from rheumatoid arthritis. One fact the medical community is certain of is that joint pain does not discriminate. We see a wide range of patients with joint pain, ranging from a young athlete to the middle-aged weekend warrior to the older adult and everyone in between.
Originally, when I was pregnant about 11 years ago, I had back pain, lower back pain and shoulder pain, and my doctor recommended that I come get some physical therapy.
Joint pain can be caused by a wide range of problems, but I would summarize joint pain into three main categories. The first would be trauma. And when I mean trauma, I'm talking about an incident or a specific injury, such as a car accident, someone who fractures their bone, or a sports injury where the joint cartilage ligament is damaged. The next main cause of joint pain would be degenerative changes, or another way to say it would be wear and tear of the joint over time. And finally, the third cause of joint pain would be considered disease. Autoimmune diseases such as lupus and rheumatoid arthritis can degenerate or cause problems in a joint. Osteoarthritis, as well as the bone density changes in the joint, such as osteoporosis.
Conservative treatments can be an effective first step for relief of painful joint conditions.
Some conservative treatments for osteoarthritis, the first step would be to do activity modification. If there are certain things like jogging that bothers your knees, either reduce the jogging or find a different exercise. Other things to try to start would be different medications, over-the-counter anti-inflammatories or Tylenol are good for pain relief. Weight reduction is another big thing. We know that obesity and body weight does have an effect on joint health, so those would be good conservative treatments to start with.
Research shows that physical therapy is one of the most effective treatments for joint pain. The American Physical Therapy Association, the American College of Rheumatology, the American Academy of Orthopaedic Surgeons, the Arthritis Foundation, the CDC are just a few organizations that recommend physical therapy for joint pain and arthritis. A physical therapist will create an individualized plan of care for a patient based on their specific impairments. Typically, that plan of care will include manual therapy, which could be massage and joint mobilization to decrease pain and improve joint mobility. We also prescribe therapeutic exercises and perform neuromuscular reeducation to help stabilize joints that have been weakened by damage, inflammation, or muscle atrophy.
Physical therapists are highly trained, licensed specialists who focus on helping patients enjoy their life free from pain and limitations. This could include helping a young mother to be able to pick up her child without pain, or allowing a firefighter to return to work after surgery, and even guiding an athlete back to the sport they love after an injury.
I received hands-on therapy, massages, and I was also given a series of exercises to do at home every day.
When a patient is suffering from joint pain, I recommend regular exercise. Flexibility and strength training have been shown to reduce pain, improve mobility and strength, which helps with function.
My results are fantastic. I am now pain-free. My lower back feels great.
There are other options if conservative treatments aren't effective.
There is some research that indicates an injection of a fibroblast growth factor can stimulate muscle healing. PRP, or plasma-rich platelet injections, are becoming very common in medical practices these days and are often used for a tendon injury as well as for arthritis.
My general rule of thumb is you should consult with an orthopedic specialist if you have pain with activity that doesn't go away after about 6 to 8 weeks.